Today we're going to talk about another trust gaming peripheral, and this time we're going to orient the review more on the keyboards. Last time we did the GXT900 gaming mouse, and today we're having the Trust Gaming Asta mechanical gaming keyboard, which has a gaming mode, anti-ghosting, direct access media keys, 7 color cycles, and all the other cool stuff. Right from the box you can see that the design is minimalistic, which I always prefer. I don't like aggressive keyboards, but this one just looks really nice, and really like the design on the matte black finish on the top. Now stay until the end of the video so you can learn more about the Trust Gaming Asta mechanical gaming keyboard. With the new release of Intel Core 10th generation processors, and if you're familiar with the Steel Legend design, then ASRock Z490 Steel Legend is the right pick for you. 10-phase power design, heat dissipating PCB technology, XXL aluminium alloy heatsink, rock solid durability, PCI Express 4.0 hardware ready for your graphics card and NVMe drives, and polychrome RGB. Check the link in the description for more information. The box content is almost the same as the GXT900 Kudos mouse. You have the GXT Trust Gaming sticker, you get the GXT865 Asta mechanical keyboard. These are legal and compliance information, and you get the manual. Let's talk about the keyboard. Now, quick responding linear mechanical switches that last up to 15 million keystrokes, 7 rainbow wave color modes with adjustable brightness. You have advanced anti-ghosting with N key rollover, special gaming mode to disable Windows key, 11 direct access media keys, anti-slip rubber feet, cable channel to optimize cable management. You also get the integrated keycap puller, and the cable channels are actually really handy when it comes to keyboards that aren't wireless. So, mechanical linear switches, which have actuation force 45 grams, minimal actuation force is 30 grams, actuation point is 2 millimeter, and total travel for the key switch is 4 millimeters. Lifespan, as I already mentioned, is 50 million clicks. Now, the keyboard, when you raise it up like this, it really has some weight to it, so it kind of gives you the sense of quality, and definitely I would agree on that. The bottom part, you have 4 rubber feet which help you stabilize the keyboard on your surface, and you have 1 additional legs to raise the keyboard and get more ergonomical, let's put it that way, ergonomical level of the keyboard, which also has rubber feet. At the bottom you have the keycap remover. I also mentioned at the back one more interesting thing, and that's the cable channel, which has 3, let's say, outputs for the cable, so you can adjust it on the far left side, you can adjust it on the far right side, and you can adjust it in the middle. The keycaps are looking really nice. They do look like some sort of an ABS plastic. The top is definitely metal, and as I said at the beginning of the video, it has this grayish design, so my presumption is that when we turn on the keyboard, the RGB lights will just look really effective. The one thing I really love about all keyboards, and Trust Gaming does have it, it has a subtle GXT Trust Gaming logo right here above the numerical pad, and that is a big plus for me because there's nothing screaming Trust Gaming, and the GXT logo is just a nice touch. You have 3 indication lights, one is for numlock, one is for screw lock, and one is for caps lock, and all multifunctional buttons are from F1 to F11, and then you have screw lock for changing the modes for the lights with the FN. FN plus escape is resetting all the profiles. So even though it doesn't have indication button, I think the FN plus F12 toggles on the gaming mode. So from F1 to F4 you have some sort of a Windows Explorer home calculator and media player. Then you have media buttons from F5 to F8 and volume buttons from F9 to F11. Let's check that RGB. When you turn on the keyboard, it really does have a nice effect, shining from the top metal part, the grayish one. It's not a gloss top plate, so it doesn't reflect that much, but you do need to take into consideration that I have two huge soft boxes right here, so it kind of lowers the lights. When we're talking about the key switch, the LED light that shines through the keycap is basically placed on top, so that's why all the letters are assigned on the top side of the keycap. The key switch, as I already mentioned, so you have 45 grams actuation force, you have 2 millimeters actuation distance, and they look like some red switches. I'm not sure if they're Otemu or some similar to those, but without a doubt, they have the MX Steam, so you could nicely change the keycaps if you want to go for something with more quality. I think the specs of the switch are quite alright, and I wouldn't say anything against that. It's quite alright, just to my liking. Now, let's test the key press and key sound. Without a doubt, I really want to hear it, and let's see if there's any additional noise when typing. The key switches don't make that kind of loud sound, they don't create any additional noise, just standard. They're actually really quiet. Of course, you can hear them, but they're not that clicky that will definitely irritate you. Now, taking into consideration that you're either typing or basically gaming, so you're just playing with the left side, or it doesn't matter. When you're using the keyboard, you don't hear any echo of the metal part, just echoing the keycap through the whole keyboard. When you press the last button, you do hear a slight sound when it comes to that echoing, especially on the space button. So the space bar does create a certain echo, but it's not that loud. I heard definitely much louder keycaps creating additional noise on the keyboard. And when typing and gaming, you won't notice it without a doubt. Just this small addition to the sound, let's put it that way. All in all, I would say a really nice keyboard. Really love the design when it comes to the subtle looks. The top metal part in gray color really doesn't leave any fingerprints or anything similar to that. You have a gloss border going all around through the whole keyboard. The switches are quite alright, I wouldn't say anything against them, just because they're 45 grams actuation force and 2 millimeters. I think that those kind of switches with those kind of specifications and not making some loud noises are definitely quite alright. The ABS plastic on the keycaps is, it's not that glossy, but I would say around 2 years they will definitely leave a glossy mark. So if you're interested in switching and going with a subtle keyboard and changing the keycaps, take that into consideration for sure. But honestly, I wouldn't say you will need that, just because it's a great keyboard for the price you're paying, and there's nothing left to it. The RGB is cool, shame it doesn't have some software backing up the RGB to adjust it as you wish, because you can only adjust it through the keyboard. So guys, yeah, this is it. I'm really satisfied with the design. This is maybe my favorite Trust gaming keyboard of all. And definitely thumbs up to Trust Gaming for making a nice subtle keyboard, which is mechanical, has nice switches, and doesn't take loads of space on your table, and that's really cool. So guys, we had the Trust Gaming GXT 865 ASTA mechanical gaming keyboard with red switches, you know the actuation force already and the actuation distance. The keycaps are alright, not perfect, not bad, just alright. The switches are cool, and that's all there is to it. I'm putting the links below for you guys to check out the prices of where to buy the Trust Gaming GXT 865 as the mechanical gaming keyboard. Just for your reference, you can check the price and all the other specifications if I miss something. Of course, if you like the video, don't forget to click the thumbs up button. And, well, if you didn't subscribe, I think it's time for future videos so you don't miss any. Thank you for watching and see you in another one. Bye-bye.